Good afternoon, and thank you for joining us today. Our presider is our pastor, Father Fernando Molina Restrepo. He's being assisted by Deacon Dave Lobo. Please rise as we begin this celebration.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
It's wonderful to see you here celebrating the great feast of love, the banquet of love with our Lord. So as we come, we do so with humility, asking the Lord to pardon our sins.
You came to heal the contrite of heart, Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
You came to poor sinners, Christe. Are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Thanks for your great glory.
us pray. God of might, giver of every good gift, put into our hearts the love of your name, so that by deepening our sense of reverence, you may nurture in us what is good, and by your watchful care, keep safe what you had nurtured. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
From the book of the prophet Jeremiah. You duped me, O Lord, and I let myself be duped. You were too strong for me, and you triumphed. All the day, I am the object of laughter. Everyone mocks me. Whenever I speak, I must cry out. Violence and outrage is my message. The word of the Lord has brought me derision and reproach all the day. I say to myself, I will not mention him. I will speak his name no more. But then it becomes like a fire burning in my heart, imprisoned in my bones. I grow weary of holding it in. I cannot endure it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, thirsting for you, my God. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, thirsting for you, my God. Thirsting for you, my God. My soul is thirsting for you.
From the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. I urge you, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God, your spiritual worship. Do not conform yourselves to this age, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, that you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and pleasing and perfect. The word of the Lord.
Be with you.
And with spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew. Jesus began to show his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and suffer greatly from the elders, the chief priests, and the scribes, and be killed, and on the third day be raised. Then Peter took Jesus aside and began to rebuke him. God forbid, Lord, no such thing shall ever happen to you. He turned and said to Peter, "Get behind me, Satan. You are an obstacle to me. You are thinking not as God does, but as human beings do." Then Jesus said to his disciples, "Whoever wishes to come after me must deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. For whoever wishes to save his life will lose it. But whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. What profit would there be for one to gain the whole world and forfeit his life? Or what can one give in exchange for his life? For the Son of Man will come with his angels in his Father's glory, and then he will repay all according to their conduct." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ. In today's Gospel, Jesus is clearly offering us a challenge. Jesus says, "Whoever wishes to save his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life for my sake will find it." We might be drawn to the conclusion that Jesus is talking about the life of our human bodies, But if we think about it, Jesus is clearly talking about the life we create for ourselves here on earth. We often get caught up in worrying about and striving for promotions, comforts, financial stability, recognition, and power. While we do have responsibilities to provide for ourselves and our families, we can lose our focus. We forget our true purpose is serving Christ and living as his disciples. It is our self-centered way of living that Jesus wants us to lose. And if we lose that in order to be more like him, we will find eternal life in heaven. Jesus wants us to challenge our priorities. Are we putting our own needs ahead of the work of the kingdom? Are we indifferent to the needs of our neighbors? It is very easy to put crosses around our necks, statues in our yards, or hang rosaries on our rear view mirrors. It is much harder to stand up and profess our faith by how we live our lives. We can post items on social media. We can go to classes to learn more about our faith. We can even wear clothes that profess our faith. But what are we doing to feed the poor? What are we doing to clothe the naked, share our faith with others, or to welcome strangers? What are we doing to help the homebound and those who are seeking justice? These are the things we must do so we can really live in a peaceful and loving kingdom, the kingdom of God. Jesus' challenge also extends to things that cannot be so easily observed. Things like what we believe in our hearts about others, how we qualify who we embrace as neighbor and brother, and how committed we are to be more like Jesus. For if we only do things for show and do not change what is in our hearts, we are really trying to save our self-centered way of life. At the end of days, that will be our downfall. We will not be safe. We will lose eternal salvation. So, if we call ourselves Christians, are we willing to accept Jesus' challenge? It will not be easy. Jesus says that from the beginning. Even Saint Peter had to be reminded that God's way is often in conflict with our own human desires. Christ insists we must let our selfish ways die so that we can live our lives in service to others. This is how we serve our Lord, not only for our own salvation, but for the salvation of the world. Who is it that Jesus calls us to embrace? It is those that we share the sacred meal with as a universal church across the world. It is those who we may have very little in common with. It is those who we are willing to stand with in solidarity and support when they are being marginalized, treated unfairly, or experiencing the pain of this world. Prayer and reflection on what is in our hearts and how we should be conducting ourselves is a great place to start in determining how far we are willing to go, how far we need to go with this gift of Christianity. Then we must act. Our eternal lives depend on it. May God bless you. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the light of the world to come. Amen. Brothers and sisters, aware of the thirst our souls have for God, let us offer up our prayers. And our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer. For the Catholic Church, may we be the church that Jesus intended in our vision, our leadership, and our membership. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parish, may a sincere commitment to God grow in our hearts and be reflected in our actions as we support our parish family and those in need. We pray to the Lord. For those who daily face poverty and potential violence, we pray for the people throughout the world that do not know abundance or peace. May humankind learn to be both human and kind. We pray to the Lord. For those suffering from natural disasters, especially for our brothers and sisters of the Gulf Coast who struggled to recover from hurricane devastation, and for those in California attempting to rebuild after horrific fires, we pray to the Lord. and for our country. May we become one nation, one family under God, regardless of economic status or racial differences. May the voices of those calling for a just society be heard. We pray to the Lord. And for the sick, especially those who suffer in mind, body, or spirit due to the pandemic, may their faith sustain them and may they be healed. We pray to the Lord. And for the repose of the soul of Maureen Lunny, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord. And for our deceased brothers and sisters, especially Brian Campbell, Antonio Villanueva, and Kit Phelps, may they rejoice in the kingdom of light, happiness, and peace. We pray to the Lord. And for your own intentions held in the silence of your heart.
Father of life, you ask that we honor you with our hearts and not just our lips. Give us the wisdom to discern your will and act as your hands toward others in need. Hear these prayers and grant them through our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept my sacrifice for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of the Holy Church.
Let us pray. May this sacred offering, O Lord, confer on us always the blessing of salvation, that what it celebrates in mystery, it may accomplish in power. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For through his paschal mystery, he accomplished the marvelous deed by which he has freed us from the yoke of sin and death, summoning us to the glory of being now called a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a people for your own possession, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works, for you had called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, and all you had created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and made them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously may holy these gifts we had brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Saint Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Gregory John Hermeyer, our Archbishop, Bernard and Joel, our auxiliary bishops, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you had gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned to be for you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of
God, now and ever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Peace.
Have mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. If you're joining us for this Mass online, please pray this prayer this time. My Jesus, on the day of my baptism, you poured your love into my heart through the Holy Spirit, who unites me eternally to you. Through that same Spirit, I pledge my love and adore you, present in your most holy body and blood. Though I cannot consume you in this sacred banquet, let me be consumed by your complete desire for me, so that my longing for you may be filled by your love alone and your mercy overflow through me into this world so in need. Amen. We walk by faith and not by sight. No gracious word we hear of him who spoke as none e'er spoke, but we believe him there. We may not touch his hands and side, nor follow where he trod. Yet in his promise we rejoice and cry, my Lord and God. Help then, O Lord, our unbelief, and may our faith abound to call on you when you are near and seek where you are found. That when our life of faith is done, in realms of clearer light, we may behold you as you are, in full and endless sight.
Now we remain with Jesus the Christ.
Let us pray. Renewed by this bread from the heavenly table, we beseech you, Lord, that being the food of charity, it may confirm our hearts and steer us to serve you in our neighbor. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our great journey, religious education classes, begin September 13th. It is more important now during this time of the pandemic to stay connected to our faith. I invite you to please register so we can continue to learn, share, and pray together. Thank you to all the families who have already registered. Thank you also to all those who are helping us to educate our children and our youth, the catechists. We need more catechists, by the way. All the information is on our website. If you need more information, please contact our religious education department. We look forward to seeing you. May God bless our new and innovative religious education programs. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Our Mass has ended. Let us go in peace. Thanks be to God.